first exposure to rheumatology occurred in medical school. I was fortunate actually to have mentors who were both rheumatologists through my medical school experience. So I was exposed early. This was at the time when we were just beginning to understand and decipher things about the immune system, largely as a result of HIV infection and AIDS. We began to understand the role, the critical role of lymphocytes in causing diseases and how their absence was leading to immunodeficiency. This is really an important time in our specialty. We began to understand that immune system and how it worked in very explicit detail. What was happening when I was in medical school and residency was that the first biological agents for the treatment of rheumatic diseases were being tested. And this was really fascinating to me, to be able to develop targeted molecules to knock out a specific part of the immune system. In this case, it was looking at downregulating T cells. But over time, I really was attracted to rheumatology as a specialty. At that time, in terms of clinical ability, we were limited in our capacity to be able to help patients in the ways that we are now. We didn't understand so much about the diseases, and we had limited therapies except for very, very potent immune-suppressing agents that caused tremendous side effects for people. But there was great opportunity, and what I saw in the rheumatologists that I worked with was their incredible compassion for the patients that they took care of. And what I saw was the opportunity to be a real doctor for patients, to understand them as individuals, and to understand these very complicated diseases that affect so many parts of the body and so many aspects of someone's health. My training in rheumatology was really at a perfect time because I saw rheumatoid arthritis, for instance, before and after. And when I say that, I mean rheumatoid arthritis before we had biologics and before we used aggressively dosed therapies. Our waiting rooms in our rheumatology clinic when I started my fellowship were filled with people in wheelchairs, and we had these special built-up chairs for people to be able to sit into. And we spent a lot of time working with our orthopedic colleagues and working with rehabilitation specialists in how to try to fix the damage that had been done. But at this time, we were doing the first trials of drugs, biological therapies for rheumatoid arthritis, and we began to see changes that were really dramatic. We had previously been using things like gold to treat patients, where not a lot of people responded and they had significant side effects. And then we started using these biological medications, first in clinical trials and then in clinical practice, that made immediate and important differences for many people treated with the diseases. And this, I think, was one of the most gratifying things to see. Was actually to see the transformation of our specialty and the focus on rheumatic diseases as something that we could treat and for which we could make real differences in the lives of patients. What's happened over time, as these biologics have become really part of our armamentarium and part of the routine treatment for people with RA, is that the disease itself has changed. RA is not the disease it used to be. We don't have waiting rooms that are filled with people in wheelchair anymore. And the reason is because we introduce more aggressive therapies early and we're able to prevent the damage that otherwise used to occur. So the specialty now is not about rehabilitating people and trying to live with disability, but trying to prevent disability from occurring in the first place. The therapies that we have really made this possible. As I look beyond rheumatoid arthritis, I see the same types of developments that are happening in other rheumatic diseases, most proximally with psoriatic arthritis and with ankylosing spondylitis, but also as we look across other diseases like lupus or vasculitis or scleroderma. Many of these conditions are where we were with rheumatoid arthritis a decade ago. The science is beginning to catch up and the targeted therapies are being able to be used. And I think this is where we're going to be headed in the future, to really make a huge impact on these illnesses that affect so many people in such significant ways.